king of Assyria, and took Ijon, and Abel Beth Maacah, and Janoah, and Kadesh, and Hazor, and Gilead, and Galilee, all the land of Naphtali, and carried them captive to Assyria.
That's right. The people, the Jewish people, the Hebrew people, everybody is now a slave. Everybody is now a slave. That's the condition of the people. Have you ever, your people at any time ever existed in darkness? Your race. Darkness. There are some Europeans and even some people in Jamaica, the islands, don't see, even Africans, straight up pure 100% African, cannot see how we submitted to slavery ever, one day. You ever wonder about that? How could you? how did your great-great-granddaddy, or great-great-great-granddaddy, or maybe further than that, how did he ever submit to being a slave? They call us African Americans weak. They don't really do it. They call us weak. This is submissive weak. Why did that happen? Well, nevertheless, we're in darkness. Today we're in darkness. Yesterday we're in darkness. The community you live in, I live in, is in darkness. They don't see nothing spiritual, nothing about the Messiah. No, no, nothing about the Messiah. They don't register. It don't come across their mind. Go forth, do business, commerce, every day, in and out. They don't think about God, not one bit. Not in my neighborhood. But the Travis around the corner, they ain't any different. So, sitting in darkness, in captivity. Captivity to what? Sickness, sin, poverty, you name it. Captivity to it. They couldn't improve their lives. They want to. They're busy, busy, trying to get to the next level economically, socially, physically, the whole nine. Just busy and dying off all the time. What's up? Can't you get some? Can't you win here? Can't you get a victory? No. No, but they'll try again in the morning. Try the same thing all day long. Try the same thing. Losing. Okay, that's the condition of the people. So, the people, Isaiah 9:2, this is what Isaiah the prophet is saying. The people that walk in darkness, all of a sudden, they saw a great light. So they got punishment, all that captivity that Kenya read about in 2 Kings is because they disobeyed God. That condition, that darkness is because they are not walking with God. And so, therefore, they have the consequences of that. Now God's bringing judgment. The people that walk through darkness have seen a great light. They dwell in the land of the shadow of death. They just despair, terrible. Now, all of a sudden, mercy. Saw a great light. Now, what we read earlier in John, 1st chapter, verse 5, they didn't know what to do. Brother Curtis, when you was out there in sin, somebody brought you a Bible. Do you know what's going on with this place? Can't you read?
Verse 1
in
chapter
9.
Verse 1 in chapter 9 talks about the condition they were in.
Isaiah 91. What's it say?
Nevertheless, the dimness shall not be such as was in her vexation, when at first he lightly afflicted the land of Zebulun and the land of Naphtali, and afterward did more grievously afflict her by the way of the sea beyond Jordan in the Galilee of the nations.
So he's punishing them for not walking with him. He's punishing the people. Can we conclude that our neighbor that's suffering from unemployment, you've got something negative, you name it, can we conclude that that situation, that condition, is because you're not walking with the Lord? I dug by y'all doing something. Can you labor, love one, employment policy? You're in this shape because you're not walking in the light of the redemption of God. You can't win because you're not walking with the Lord. You wouldn't go with that? Anybody wouldn't go with that? Nobody? That's why I like sermons.
Did somebody say yes?
Pretty much.
You're losing because you're losing. Can't win. Get up every day, busy body, boom, 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 boom. Get up in the morning, try it again. I'm still sick, I'm still dying, I'm still broke. House is upside down, family's all over the place. I can't get nowhere in life. What is going on?
I don't agree to it. 100%.
Okay. Explain this. Your essay, please.
Same thing with Joel. Look exactly. What happened to him.
Job. Job wasn't in captivity.
He wasn't in captivity, but look at all the things he went through. He wasn't in captivity, but he suffered.
Well, okay.
He suffered.
All right.
He suffered. He wasn't in captivity, but what's the difference?
Oh, so say your neighborhood's like that? Our community, our nation is like Job's? All these are Job's? We're saying that this is as a people.
2 weeks ago, we had good things happen to
bad things happen
to bad things happen to good people. Yeah. What's the difference between this and that?
We're speaking here as a people, as a nation, as a people. There are in, that's why I said your neighborhood, all this, your community, North Tulsa. Are we walking in light and experiencing these problems? Are we walking in darkness?
I'm going to say this, Pastor Donnell.
Go ahead, brother.
It's the same thing with the church.
Go ahead.
My opinion, not no one else's opinion. You got more church people, it's divided than more of these streets people.
Well, I see where you're coming from. What about the spiritual condition?
I can't answer that because I don't know what spiritual condition each person has.
But we're not speaking as
He's speaking as a group.
I think he's speaking as a group.
Okay, still as a group. Still as this group right here. We're going to speak about Northside. Still as this group right here. We're not together. I don't think so.
You're talking about North Tulsa community?
No, North Tulsa church.
North Tulsa church?
Community, we show not together, North Tulsa community.
Let's put it like that.
Yeah.
As a community, and then you spread onto it as a state, as a nation. We are not walking in the light.
No.
Because these people that we read in 2 Kings were not walking with what they had, the knowledge of what was provided to them through the prophets and so forth, they found themselves in captivity.
But someone had to speak up. Someone had to speak up.
They had the prophets.
Right. Someone had to speak up.
What they do to the prophets? They killed the prophets. We're going to live like these Gentiles. Have his wife and her wife and their wife, and we're going to do some same-sex marrying and all this and all that, and kill the babies, eat the babies, and all this kind of stuff. This is how the Gentiles live. This is what we're going. We like the way the Gentiles are living like that. And we got God's law. Remember, we start off the first 5 books. Is this a law right here? And they didn't go for it. They didn't like it. So Isaiah said, look at the condition that we're in as a people.
Do you think that we got in that condition because they were afraid of the way that the Gentiles were living there and the belief that they had that if we lived the way we're living, they're going to kill us and they were afraid of dying?
There's a lot of reasons for people choose not to walk in the knowledge of what they had. For example, Adam chose. Why did you choose not to walk in the light that you got? This woman you
did. I'm just got straight footed. That's all.
The same condition is just as permeated to everybody. Food. You just straight. Y'all just straight fools. Collectively. Now how are we gonna straighten this out? Because a woman says, God looked down and saw, not one of them walking in my life. no 911. All the world can become what? Guilty before God. The arbitrator, the ultimate judge, pronounce everybody guilty. What is he going to say? So that's his judgment. And where is the mercy? Light. Give them light. Give them some light. They're guilty, accountable. Guilty as can be, every one of them. But I'm going to give them light. That's my mercy. And when the light hit them, St. John 1 and 5, they didn't know what to do with the light. They didn't know what to do with the light. Now what we're going to do? End of Isaiah 9 and 2, upon them had shined, upon them had the light shine. Okay, now, because that light shined, I would call that light a gift. What about you? I would call the light a gift. I don't know why I want to go to way over there in the Bible, in the book of the letters of John. It says, if we walk in the light, as he's what? In the light. I'm probably going to help Brother Curtis out a little bit. Those people that are, you know, I'm identifying the condition of a people. I mean, I know in my neighborhood, it's bad. Travis, I'm usually around the corner. Might be a little bit better around here. But it's just bad. They don't get up to worship. No God. How many got in your way going to church this morning? Anybody? You have a slowdown in the street traffic because everybody's coming out their driveway?
In my block, my little stretch,
there's
probably three families, including myself.
Yeah.
That gets up.
That's going to grace the church house door, some church house door this morning. Sometime today, I'm going to grace the church house door. The majority of them get up in the morning, Monday morning, they start the same routine over and over and over. Battle for victory and keep losing by the week's over.
Say that one more time. You said what?
Battle or strive for victory in life and still come up with the same results at the end of the day.
You're going to get better on Monday morning.
Go get a Monday morning, go hit it. Some of them going to lose out in life, and some of them going to, but they are not going to get victory over that sin or that degrading thing that's attacking them. The light, the Word of God. Can you make it down here without the Word of God?
No, you can't.
No?
You definitely can't.
So, and if they don't have it, and we know who's responsible for getting the Word to them, it's the people of God. Those that care. That's what Isaiah is right now. Isaiah is a one in, kind of like John the Baptist, one in the wilderness crying out. And here's Isaiah in the midst, prophesying. In the midst of all of this, he's part of the people. But he's being used to prophesy.
The man, you this, how many people you think acknowledge that this word is here in your neighborhood?
Not too many of them. But it's not real to them. That's the Bible. Let's see if I can dig it out somewhere.
Borrow
from next door. I'll go to the store and buy one like that. They may have one in the house laying open on the coffee. The glass coffee table just laying down open, you know, collecting dust. On the headboard of the bed, in the back seat of the car.
When light comes, darkness tries to hide.
So the light shines. So I would say the light is a gift. The light is not the judgment. The light is the gift. You throw that, say he forgives it that light. Now what is that gift? What is that light? Let's see here. St. John 3:16. Believe not the church. What's the glory? The light was a gift. The light was a gift. The light is a promise. Part of the promise. When Adam and Eve sinned, I think it's, I want to say 3:16, Genesis 3:16. I think. It's the promise. His judgment, he put judgment on them. Boom. Now you got to work if you want to use. Now, woman, you got to obey him. Boom. Now, when you multiply and have children, you do it in sorrow. You're going to have a lot of pain now. That's the judgment. His seed shall bruise thy heel. I mean, your head should bruise this somewhere, man. You know where I'm coming from. Let me see here. 3:14. And the Lord said unto the serpent, because thou hast done this, thou art cursed above all cattle, above every beast of the field. Upon thy belly shalt thou go, and dust shalt thou eat all the days of thy life. Verse 15, and I will put enmity between thee and the woman, and between thy seed and her seed. God said, this is what I'm going to do. It's a promise. It shall bruise thy head, and thou shalt bruise his heel. And then his promise was thy seed and her seed. God promised a seed. The woman don't have no seed. The man's got the seed. He says her seed. It's a promise. So when that promise is the light. I'm getting you bad, but here's mercy for all the rest of, for all of creation. Not just the man and the woman, but all of the creation was cursed. Even the snake is cursed. All the animals is cursed. Everybody needs this promise to come forward, to come out up under this mess we're in. All right, now let's look at the mess. I mean, let's look at the promise. Okay, verse 3 of the lesson. Thou hast multiplied the nations and not increased the joy. And not increased the joy. You have grown the nation. And has not, it is not that much fun to be a part of this nation. Families growing all the time, man. We're getting more sinners all the time. They enjoy before thee according to the joy and harvest. But now it's a flip from what he just said, and not increase the joy. Now it's the flip. Now we're full of joy, just like harvest time. Harvest time, that 7-year jubilee and all like that. Oh, everybody's happy, relieved with debt. This is how I imagine you feel if you don't owe a damn to nobody. Oh, yeah, I'm happy automatically. And as men rejoice when they divide the spoil. Like when I went to war and I won the war and we got all this gold and silver, now we're just going to divvy it up. We relax and give out everybody a share. Yeah. Everybody's happy. Woo, because we got that light. We got the light. We got the gift. What is the gift now? The gift, like we say in John 3:16. Verse 4. For thou hast broken the yoke of his what? Burden. Now, people in the country, what's the yoke? Farmers. What's the yoke? You got the cattle. Was that right? It's the thing on his head. Yeah. And he's burdened down. He's got the yoke. He got to get out there and work no matter what. And the yoke, he can't run away or nothing. That yoke is too heavy for him. And that's what the government is doing to people that don't have a life. He's working. How do you know? Get up, I guarantee you, get up in the morning, just sit on your front porch and look out. And just take a note. Get your notebook. Go to the quick trip. They're on their way to that J-O-B. And some of them got good jobs and making good money, but the money is not doing what it's supposed to do. It's not like making enough money, but still not having enough. Because of what? Foolishness. No budget. No control, no nothing. God not blessing the seed that you're getting in, and it's just working and just working. And, still broke, still behind. They're not tithing. That's not giving. They don't know the law of giving. Oh, man, they just get up, and then you catch them again on Tuesday, you do the same thing. Oh, look, they get right on. What is it? Stressed out. Some of them stressed out. It's called a yoke. That yoke. It's the yoke of the burden. The yoke of the burden of labor. The burden of labor. So he says, God has broken the yoke of his burden and the staff of his shoulders, that's hard on the animal, and then the rod of his suppressor. Here it is. How many got a job that if you get sick and you miss so many days, you're out of here? Have you ever heard about a job like that? Yeah. Some of us are blessed that we got a little leeway. You know, you can be sick half a year and they still welcome you back with open arms. Some of them, 6 hours and you're out of here. Man, still striving every day to feed his family, get everything going. And he missed, take off half a day, wrong time of the day. He's missed, that's that rod. Bam, you better get here or else I'm going to fire you. Working sick, can't hardly stand up, got a fever. That's the rod driving you to work. That devil is driving you with that rod of oppression. That don't happen for you.
Oh, yeah.
they let you take off till you get better.
It's real.
Till you start feeling like it, you want to come on, they'll let you come on in there, right? And so, okay, for every battle of the warrior is with confused noise, and garments roll in blood, but this shall be with burning and fuel of fire. I'm getting to the heavy stuff here. Someone read verse 6, if you will.
What? For unto us a child is born, and unto us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder. And his name shall be called Wonderful, Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace.
Now look at all these attributes. And Psalms 2, verse 6. Set my king upon my holy hill of Zion. I will declare the decree. The Lord has said unto me, thou art my son. This day have I begotten. In other words, this day I've made you alive again. Now, verse 6 of what we just read over there in Isaiah says, for us a child is born. A child is born, but you're giving me a son. Now, what's going on here? And the government, let's look at it like this. Is the government with the child or with the son? Question for the class. Is the government, is the child ruling or is it the son ruling? Says, and the government's on his shoulders as a son or as a child. Which one is happening? The son. Okay. The significance of the child. Until I say what? A child is born.
Yeah.
What's the uniqueness about the child? Hold up, bro. There's a child without sin. A child born without sin. Have you ever heard of such a thing?
Once before.
Mm-hmm. Have you ever heard of such a thing? A person can come into this world and escape the sin nature. Adam. There's only one that's known that. It's called the first Adam. He came in here without sin. Now we got another. That's the uniqueness of the child. You got a child, a sinless child, and now you got a government. He'll put a government on his shoulders. The government of mankind, the government of God's creation. He's going to be the final arbitrator now because he's sinless. And his name should be called Jesus. His name should be called what? Wonderful. Why are you doing that? Well, it's also going to be called what? Counselor. The Mighty God. The Everlasting Father.
Prince of Peace.
The Prince of Peace. Because he's going to be the arbitrator that keeps all of that in order. When you see the Son, he's wonderful because, well, he can do it just like anything. It's wonderful. He's a counselor because he sits down and he gives wisdom to people. Go to him and get some understanding. He'll get this straight. Go sit down and get some counsel. Get some direction. Since the day he got here, that's what he does, is he's been counseling people. Oh, okay. Let's keep going. What's after the counsel? The Mighty God. The Everlasting Father. Everlasting Father means that he has he's the eternal, everlasting, eternal one over his creation. How many people in your neighborhood know this? My neighborhood, they don't. I said the Everlasting Father, they might get that. I said, counselor, you can go talk to the counselor. They're going to call up the school system. You need to give it to counsel. Get you some wise counsel. Oh,
hey, how are
you? Yeah. When I go to DHS, get this. Where do you get this from? Get you some counsel. Need some wise counsel. I dare say, we can boldly tell people that we're helping and working around. You need to go get some wise. You need to get some wise counsel. Well, who was that? Where are you going to get that? See, 1 Corinthians 1:30 says, and he's given unto us wisdom. You get some wisdom from him if you go to him. Okay. All right. Now, and of the increase. And of the increase of his government, well, we know who's going to be in there. Who's going to be in, make up this government? When Jesus comes back to rule on the earth, who's in that government? What citizenry makes up that government? The increase of his government. His government is growing. The citizenry is growing. Where are they coming from? There could be some Hebrews in there, Jews. Of his government. People get tripped up. Preachers get, this preacher might get thrown out of church. The church is going to be his government. That's what they're called. The church. It's the church of government. Is the church a government? Jesus said, upon this rock I'll build my church. Upon this rock I'll build my government. Never did say that the church would be a part of the government. And I said last week, the church is a body of what? Believers. Body assembly. Church means what? Assembly. Government means ruler. So who's going to be increasing his government? Now write that down, put it in your think tank. The government is going to be the people that he, increase of his government will be on the earth, those ruling in his government that he ruled. The church is going to be the church. It's a different entity than Israel. Am I right? Is the church a unique entity? Put that in your think tank and think it over. Is the church different? It's a different entity in the earth than God's chosen people. Hello, my Hebrew scholar. I'm going to say that now the Jews are God's chosen what? The Messiah come through the Jewish people. And then we got this church. Who in the world is that?
They were adopted into the family.
These Gentiles. So we have a habit of throwing everybody into the same boat. There we go. But the increase of his government, the church is going to be, you know, they get raptured out of here. So take some special study to figure out the church and everybody else. There's a difference. For the increase of his government and peace, there should be no end. Upon the throne of who? David. And upon his kingdom. Now you think the Gentiles, if Isaiah was talking to Gentiles, they'd know exactly what he's talking about. They'll go to some of them heathens. And on the house of David, he's going to set up his throne. He's going to preach to a bunch of Gentiles. Who? David. But if I go to the Jewish community and I say, and I'm in the house of David, think they know what I'm talking about? David, yeah, we know. Yeah. Well, see, it says right here about David's throne. But the Gentiles, they don't know nothing about the throne of David. They're not familiar with that. That's something to put in your think tank. Finish that. And of the increase of his government and peace, there should be no end upon the throne of David and upon his kingdom. Now get out of here. To order it, to establish it with judgment and with justice from henceforth and forever. Now, if you think David's kingdom is operating on the earth right now, I got a bridge I'm going to sell you. And if you think Isaiah is talking to some Gentiles, I got a bridge I want to sell you. Isaiah is talking to Jewish people that knows what this stuff is. Gentiles, we don't know. We're scratching our head. We got adopted into this stuff. We're not familiar with this stuff. Then again, and the church, guess what? It leaves out of here early. Boom, it's gone. Now what's left? Something's on the earth. It's a mess. It's chaos. Light's going to have to shine on it again. Don't shine on the earth. And those people down there is going to have to get their act together because he's coming back to judge the earth, be the final arbitrator on the earth. And you think you're going to put on your little hat and be sitting up there and judging too. And he said, who are you? I'm a Gentile. What do you know about the Pentecost? Nothing. What are you? Let's mess with y'all. We try to take over everything that's the church. Church has its spot, its place, and it's uplifted out of here. End time. Little end time study. Put in your thank you. Church ain't doing everything. The zeal of the Lord of hosts. Who's going to figure this out, get this done? The zeal of the Lord of hosts. The zeal of the Creator. He's going to get this figured out. But that's just something to do in your thank you. Thank you. Everybody think the church is going to do everything. It has this time period. It's going to be a time when the time to preach is have churches out open, out of business. Church out of business. Well, I mean, they got right through the line here. What's left? Chaos. Light. Then the Messiah comes. The Messiah is going to come rescue Israel. End of the story. Fast forward. The Messiah is going to come rescue his people. We call it Armageddon. He's going to come rescue them when everybody's coming against the tiny nation of Israel. They need help. Here he comes. Boom, it's light. He's not going to do that. Allow all that stuff to happen as long as, guess who's in the earth? The church. As long as the church is in the earth, all that chaos and all that kind of stuff ain't happening. Why? Because the church is a special little entity. That takes a more in-depth study. All right, well, I hope to help you out.